Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome back to the Keith Miller Arena inside the East Hand Sportsplex. Game number 9 of the 2024 U18 AAA Atlantic Hockey Championships here on AO Live. My name is Mike Barkhouse. Please be with you again for the 9th time over the last 3 days. Ashton Rieke to my right bringing you the action shots. This game 9 features the final game of the round robin for both of these teams. It's the Moncton Flyers against the Steel Subaru U18. So much on the line in this game. We'll break down the permutations for you here momentarily after the national anthem. But this is a big one. And it's two heavyweight programs in the U18 ranks in Atlantic Canada that are contesting it. So we're going to pause now for O Canada, and we'll set you up for puck drop right after this. That's going to do it. O'Kane in the books, almost set for puck drop from East Hand. Starting goaltenders today for the Flyers, it's Loic Nadeau. Second start of the tournament for him. He was in goal for the loss yesterday morning versus the Halifax Max. And at the other end, Marty King switching up the rotation. Second consecutive start for Brandon Lavoie. He's going to carry the mail the rest of the way in this tournament for Steel Subaru. 1-1 in the tournament. But a 9.63 save percentage for Brandon Lavoie. So this is a big one. We'll talk about the standings here once we get puck drop. We are underway here in Lance. Game number 9 of the Atlantics, and it is a big, big one. And the physicality early on is apparent between these two teams trying to set the tone. Now a scrum in front, just 20 seconds into this hockey game, and already emotions are running high. So here's how it sits. The Kensington Wild, just in the game prior to this, defeated the Pinnacle Growlers 7-0 to advance. They've punched their ticket. They've clinched first place and a berth in tomorrow afternoon's championship game. Second place right now is Halifax, 2-1 with 6 points and a +4 goal differential. Steel Subaru, 1 point behind Halifax. They sit at 2-1, but of course one of those wins was an overtime win, not a regulation win. So they have 5 points and a +2 goal differential, 1 point behind Halifax. So we're going to get a power play here for Moncton. Early, just 20 seconds in. Flyers, meanwhile, 1-2, 3 points, -6 goal difference. So they're essentially out of contention. But best they can do is win this in regulation, tie Halifax, and hope Halifax loses. But again, the goal difference is a problem. Halifax has +4. Halifax would have to get blown out by Pinnacle in that game for Moncton to advance. So this one's just about pride pretty much for the Flyers. But again, Steel Subaru, a win of any kind will vault them past Halifax and into second place. But Halifax still plays after this against the Growlers. So Steel probably needs a 3-point regulation win to move 2 points ahead of Halifax. And then they're going to need some help from the Growlers. So that's the standings set up here. 1:05 left to go on this first Flyers man advantage. Sanchez on the near wall. Back to the point to Connor Sturgeon. That puck looked to come out, and the linesman agrees. Offside on the Flyers. That's going to bring the faceoff out of neutral ice. 59 seconds to go in the Flyers' power play. These two teams don't play in the same league as one another, but don't think for a second that they're not familiar with one another. These are big, two big programs in Atlantic Canada, always meeting each other at in-season tournaments like the Ice Jam, like the Moncktonian, and of course, tournaments like this as well over the years. Certainly there's familiarity there. And of course, these players all come up playing against one another in minor hockey as well. Liam Dagg scored his first of the tournament yesterday, fires that off a body and over the glass. 35 seconds to go in the Flyers' power play. Faceoff will stay in the Subs zone. Appreciate all you tuning in on AO Live this morning, whether this is your first time checking us out or if you've been with us through the whole tournament. We appreciate each and every one of you. Far and wide. I'm sure we've got some viewers watching from some pretty obscure places. That's typically the case. O'Brien now over to Dagg in the far corner over by the Zamboni gate. Sturgeon over to O'Brien. 15 seconds in the power play now. Sturgeon, wrist shot stopped by, I think it stopped by Lavoie. Yeah, it was. It did get to Lavoie and he made the save. Heavy snapshot there from Connor Sturgeon. Now he fires it over to Dagg. He's got some room. Fires it off a leg and then I think Lavoie kicked the right pad out. And keep that one out on the redirect. Power play is over. Back to five aside, we remain scoreless here in game number 9. Two games to go after this one. The final round robin game at 3 p.m. Atlantic, and then the big one tomorrow afternoon for all the marbles. A trip to the TELUS Cup is on the line tomorrow afternoon. Kensington versus to be determined. Sturgeon gloves this at the red line and skates it in. Good job by Baxter to stay onside. Dagg is bumped off the puck by Brady Burke as we approach the 3-minute mark of this intense first period. Big hit down in the offensive zone by Richard. He's been penalized numerous times in this tournament. Three that I can think of right off the bat. He's an agitator, but he also scored his first goal yesterday. Brendan O'Donnell now loses that. Picked up by Austin Sanchez. Slides it ahead looking for Summers. That doesn't connect. O'Donnell with it now. This is Brennan. Sends it into the Moncton zone. Caleb Sear picks it up. Over to Luc Moraes. Luc Moraes bumped by Blake Manders. Now away comes Aiden O'Donnell. Top prospect for the upcoming Ontario Hockey League draft. And there are multiple OHL teams here this week getting viewings of him. Sanchez over to Dami Seo. Gets around Wyatt Countway. Seo spins back in the corner. Countway shoves him. It's to Jace Evans. And Seo sends it down low. Evans and Béliveau give chase. Elliot Cavanaugh with it near corner. Gets it ahead to the point. Zach Gill can't keep that in. Speaking of top Q prospects, Zach Gill is another one. Sanford now. Backhand pass. Countway keeps it in at the point. Just. And then sends that into some feet. Sanford back to Countway. Over here to Cavanaugh. Cavanaugh. Wrist shot. That's off of McQueen and to the corner. McQueen, Gill shoves him. Simon Bork comes out the far side for the Flyers. Bork gets the red line, sends it deep. Lavoie out of the net, will leave it. And ahead comes Cavanaugh. Puts it right on Owen O'Donnell, he'll send it deep. Nadeau stays in the goal. This one's past LeBlanc and the captain Sanchez picks it up. Sends it through neutral ice. Nathan Weber on the far side. Now he has to wait as he put a couple of linemates onside with his hesitation. Now he'll flip it into the near corner. Almost 5 minutes into this first period. The pace in this one is noticeably faster than the pace of our first game earlier this morning. Owen O'Donnell to Mäkinen. There's a bump and the Subs are dispossessed. Here comes Sanchez over the blue line. He's got Nekas Jong with him. And that goes the other way now. Tucker Mäkinen, he's runs into a wall. Of course, the Subs fans want a call, not gonna get it. Weber chips it to Jean. His father, Fritz Bergevin Jean, the goaltending coach of the Tampa Bay Lightning, was here yesterday to watch Neca play. He had to go back and join the NHL team tonight, but he was here yesterday. It's good to see him. 2-0, shots on goal in favor of the Flyers. 14:29 to go first period. We are scoreless here in game number 9 of the Atlantics. Glad to be with you on AO Live, the home of the Atlantic Hockey Championships. Stag. Gives that away. Prince now. This is the Chike Uzujuku. To LeBlanc on the backhand. That's off the side of the goal. Now comes right out front. Nobody in blue could get a stick to that. Liam Dagg skates it away now. Dagg has that slide down right onto Lavoie. Paddle down, makes the save, and holds on. That's the third shot of the afternoon for the Moncton Flyers. Subs still looking for their first shot on goal. 14:09 to go, first period. Faceoff will come to the left of Brandon Lavoie. Subs win the draw. Jake Prince takes it behind his goal out the far side. Prince moves it ahead now. Prince around Dagg. Prince tries to chip it past Gucci. Can't do that. Now Caleb Sear picks it up inside his own zone. Down in the corner. Spins away from Uzuchukwu. Gucci over to Jacob Pino. Pino over the red line. Sends off the skate of Prince. Now LeBlanc with a shot. That doesn't get through. Pino in, trying to get that back to Olivier LeBlanc. Scrum down there by the Zamboni gate. LeBlanc comes away with it, but now loses it to Prince. He'll come out the near side. Soup still looking for their first shot on goal. Not going to get it here. Connor Sturgeon takes over. Far side, LeBlanc couldn't take that carry off the boards. Lavoie leaves it for Blake Manders. Flyers are changing as Manders brings it up ice. Manders over to Owen O'Donnell, trying to get around Sturgeon. No can do. Zach Gill there to pick that up. Of course, his brothers Spencer and Dylan already playing in the queue. Baxter's knocked down from behind. Thought we might see a call there. Referee's arms remain down. Owen O'Donnell back the other way. 3-on-2 for the Subs if they hurry. Sends it ahead. Evans and Gill give chase. McQueen with it now below the goal line. Has it pinned there. Now tries to get it behind the goal. Coming out, stuffing it at the side is Evans. And Luek Nadeau has it. 12:52 to go in the first period. Still scoreless here in game number 9. Of course, with all the rage going on, there's a flurry of activity going on all around me right now. In the previous game, there was an incident between the Pinnacle Growlers and the Kensington Wild between the benches. That is quite the topic of conversation here. It involved Matt McDonald and backup goaltender Scott Kirby of the Growlers. And it's being reviewed for possible supplementary discipline. So we're talking to head referees. We're talking to tournament organizers here while we're calling this game. There's a whole lot of action going on. And what would you expect? It's day 3 of the Atlantics. We're getting down to the nitty-gritty now. It was quite a hot-button topic between games, even in the crowd and over in the cafe, the hospitality area. Everyone's talking. It's Atlantics. Nick Hajon tried to find it through to Summers. Can't find him. Supes do have their first shot on goal, courtesy of McQueen moments ago. Now they're going to get their first power play. It's a cross-checking call, and it's going to be Nick Hajon. As skilled as he is, he does have a hot temper sometimes as well. First power play of the afternoon for the Subs, about to get underway, looking to draw first blood with 12:19 to go in the first. Faceoff will come to the left of Loic Nadeau. And here we go. Flyers control off the draw. LeBlanc sends that over the glass and out. Just over the glass, not by a whole lot. So that was O'Brien, not LeBlanc. Olivier O'Brien. Just 5 seconds comes off the clock on this power play for Steele. Face off to the right of Nadeau, won by the Flyers again. Luc Morais to Mr. O'Brien now. Stevens has it and the Subs set up. Owen O'Donnell. Down low. Stevens to Mäkinen. Mäkinen has to hurry. Now Sanchez tries to spring Weber. Lavoie is going to come out of the net to play this away from Weber. Mäkinen on the far side is going to take a bump from Sanchez. Subs having all kinds of trouble right now establishing possession and getting this power play set up. Weber over to the near side. He's going to kill more clock. Sends it back to O'Brien. Not ideal here for Steele. O'Brien will send it the length of the ice. And now perhaps the Subs will be able to bring it forward and set it up. Almost halfway through this power play. Nothing doing so far. Tucker Mäkinen gives that away. And here comes Olivier LeBlanc. 1-on-3. Shorthanded. Taken down. Flyers fans call the penalty. Referee does not. Brady Burke, far side. Skates past Baxter. absorbs the contact, gets it deep. 45 seconds to go on the power play. Gucci rims it around. Will Prince be able to keep it in the near point? Yes, Prince gives that away. Now gets it back. Gets it to McPhee. Cole McPhee down low. Brendan O'Donnell spins away from Gucci, but Gucci gets it back and lifts it all the way down. 25 seconds to go on the power play as Prince is back for it. Moncton would love to play spoiler here for the Soobs and end Steele's season. Almost said Dartmouth. First time I've done that this week. Aiden O'Donnell shoots, and that didn't miss by much on the glove side. Highly touted prospect, maybe the highest touted prospect in this entire event. And he's going to the OHL. Prince, cross corner dump in. Penalty is over. Both teams 0 for 1 on the man advantage in this hockey game so far. Gill, far side. Moves it ahead. Pino couldn't come up with that cleanly. Halfway through the first period, moving at a lightning clip here in this opener. Again, the comparison between the earlier game and this one, well, there is no comparison. This one is being played at a high, high level with so much on the line. Faceoff, that whistle goes there, sorry. Shots on goal, 3-2 in favor of the Flyers. We've got 9:52 to go first period. Still awaiting the game's first goal here in Lance on AO Live. And live is indeed what we are. Kavanaugh. Down low to Tristan LeBlanc. It's a Chukwu battling with Béliveau. Sanford now wheels it out with Sayo watching him. Sanford gets it deep. Nadeau to the net, plays it over far side for Dami Sayo. Sanford tried to get it down low. Sayo steps in front of that, and away he goes. Dami Sayo, Béliveau is with him. Béliveau can't get to that. Gucci has it near point. Bork digs it out, but now he's going to lose it. It's going to squeak out. Flyers have to clear the zone. Mokryakov now. Stretch pass, trying to catch the Flyers, changing. Uzuchukwu with a shot right on, and Loic Nadeau makes the save. That evens things up on the shot count at 3 apiece. 8:59 to go, first period. Tied at zeros. Soobs win this draw back to McPhee, but a little too hot for him to handle, so he's got to retreat now. Soobs send it back in. Evans. He's looked good in this tournament. He's a Q draft eligible player. Back comes Jackson Summers now. Very close on the far blue line in terms of offside. Shaw appeared to stay on. Shaw now gets it to Summers. Baxter's lurking out front. O'Brien down low to Baxter. Now trying to get through everybody as McQueen does, but he lost his footing, so he wasn't able to get the puck over to Stevens. Here comes Morai with speed through neutralized. Luke Morai, been a big fan of him this week. Baxter centers, that's off a leg. Now comes out in front, did hit a skate. Luckily for LeBlanc, for Prince, it didn't go on goal. Now Nekajon dancing around into the offensive zone, loses the handle. Prince picks it up, lifts that off glass high, avoids the rafters. And now this is offside. O'Donnell's has to clear the zone. Aiden has it, gets it over to Brennan. Brennan O'Donnell over the blue line, sends it deep. Gill sends that to Sanchez. Sanchez up into the equipment of Brennan O'Donnell. He'll send it back in. Gill finds that. Partner pass over to Weber. Weber takes a bump, and here comes Owen O'Donnell. Tucker Mackinnon races it in. Mackinnon takes it. Stopped by Ledo. Good save by Loic Nadeau right there. Tucker Mackinnon got a good shot away. Sturgeon lifts this out into neutral ice. Now swing and a miss for Conway. Here comes Sanchez, and Jean was offside. Tough break there for Neca Jean. And the chatter between the benches continues. 4-3, shots on goal in favor of Steele. Still scoreless, 6:50 to go, first period. Subes win the draw. Kavanaugh ahead, looking for O'Donnell. That's broken up. Pino pokes it to Dagg. Liam Dagg, wrist shot over the crossbar. Dagg's a Gatineau draft pick. Amherst Rambler draft pick as well. Centering pass from Dagg. Gucci has it. Fans on the wrister. And away comes Tucker Mäkinen. Not as quick as he was moments ago, as he's towards the end of the shift. And Gucci bodies him off the puck. Here comes Dagg now. Liam Dagg trying to get around Kavanaugh. Kavanaugh plays that well. But now he ices the puck. Icing waved off. So Caleb Searer back to get it. We play on. Pace in this one continues to be high. Mokryakov sends that ahead. O'Brien takes over. Skips over LeBlanc's stick. This is going to be an icing call on the Flyers with 6:02 to play in the first period. As I mentioned, one game remaining in the round robin. That will follow this game at 3 p.m. Atlantic time. We were at it bright and early this morning, a 9 a.m. start for the first game. So conversely, that means we get out early tonight. It's like school dismissal. Pinnacle Growlers and Halifax Max will close the round robin at 3 p.m. Atlantic, 3:30 p.m. Newfoundland time. And then one more after that. Tomorrow, 1 p.m. Atlantic, the Atlantic Championship game. Kensington Wild out of Prince Edward Island versus to be determined. Icing called there on the Subes. 5:42 to go, first period. The way this one's going, we'll be done by one. I don't think so. I kid. Here comes Sanford now. LeBlanc, cross corner dump in. Moray back for it. Moray ahead to Sayo, to Bork. Bork being hounded by Manders and now forces the turnover. Mäkinen to Sanford, shoots. Stopped by Nadeau. Prince down low for Mäkinen. Sorry, for it was for the other member of that line, Evans. And now wake up Sayo. Head to Beliveau. He'll airmail this one in way over the glass and out of play. First stoppage, 5-3. The shots on goal in favor of the Subes. No score. 5:03 to go in the first. Collision at the red line off of this draw. Moncton control. Zach Gill. Head looking for Summers. He pokes that in. Lavoie came out of the net. Didn't play it. Left it for Manders. Under 5 minutes to go in the first period now. Evans pokes at it. Gets it. Now slides it over to Owen O'Donnell. O'Donnell. McQueen trying to catch up to that. Sturgeon has it on the far side. Connor Sturgeon. Ahead for Summers. Pokes that around Aiden O'Donnell. Now Aiden O'Donnell gets it out. Head to Owen O'Donnell. Three O'Donnells on this Steel Subaru squad. Brendan O'Donnell, toe drag! That's off the blocker of Nadeau. Good save by him there. He has come to play today. Aiden O'Donnell. Sturgeon picks it up behind the goal. Takes a whack from Brendan O'Donnell. That's two big boys there doing battle. Summers tries to get it through to Jean. Lavoie's going to play it. Now Aiden O'Donnell brings it ahead. Aiden O'Donnell with speed into the zone. Jean hooking him from behind. Brendan O'Donnell tries to get to Aiden. Now he and Weber give chase. O'Donnell bumps Weber. Weber comes away with it. Good stick lift from Neca Jean. Sanchez over the red line. Sends that deep. Countway lifts it back the other way. Brendan O'Donnell has it. Weber looked like he was going to keep it in, but ends up retreating instead. And sent in by Caleb Sear. Lavoie plays it. Owen, so Brendan O'Donnell through to Owen. He's got Brady Burke over on the far side. Gets a good shot away. Nadeau stops that as well. Brady Burke back to Mokryakov. Sends that intentionally wide. Owen Donald battling with Sear behind the goal. There's a chance in front. Doesn't go anywhere. McPhee sends it back down low. Sanchez picks it up here on the near boards. Jean over to Weber. Under three to go in the first. Weber is a man on an island right now all by himself. Subs take over. Stevens across the middle. LeBlanc intercepts that. And here comes Liam Dagg. Liam Dagg goes wide. Now centers. That's broken up nicely by Mokryakov. Half board battle. Comes back to O'Brien at the point. Over to Morey. Morey, wrist shot, redirected on the way in. That goes just wide of the blocker side of Lavoie. Now Jacob Pino. Back to O'Brien. O'Brien fakes the pass. Now gets it to Pino. Touches it down to Dagg. Dagg centers. That's off Lavoie's stick. Luc Morey. Bumped by Stevens. Loses the handle now, and the Subs take over. McPhee lifts it into Morey's chest. That's a bad clearance and a takeaway. Dagg shoots. That whistles over the goal. Funny bounce off the stanchions. And now Mäkinen tried to spring Stevens. Elects to take it himself now. Gets it to Stevens. Stevens waits. Looks like he was about to shoot. Now he gets it back to Prince. Prince, wrist shot. Blocked down by Pino on the way in. And away come the Flyers. LeBlanc sends it deep. Lavoie stops it. Plays it ahead. Misses Uzuchukwu, and that's going to be an icing call on the Subs. Tough break there for Brandon Lavoie. 7-3 shots on goal in favor of the Subs. Loic Nadeau has been good here in this first period. 1:33 to go in the first. And we are scoreless here in game number 9 of the Atlantics. Prince. Head to Sanford. Jacob Sanford. Through to LeBlanc. Uzuchukwu. Sanford. Down low. Sturgeon battling with Jace Evans. Sorry, Tristan LeBlanc. Gill. Now a good read there by Manders. Knocking that away from Seau. Seau gets it back though. Seau tries to find Béliveau. Subs send it off glass. Not out yet. Now it will be out as we hit 1 minute to play in the first. Tristan LeBlanc sends it deep. Nadeau behind the goal. Plays it forward to Seau at the red line. Countway marking him. Seau waiting for some help. It's not forthcoming, so he just turns and fires it down low. Lavoie leaves it for Kavanaugh. 35 seconds to go. Stevens banks this one in. O'Brien to Summers, tries to get it to Baxter. Kavanaugh sends it back deep. Stevens gives chase along with Morey. Stevens centers, O'Brien steps in front of that. 20 seconds to go in the period. Summers ahead to Baxter. Baxter loses the puck as he cut inside. Subs send it back out to neutral ice. O'Brien ahead to the Subs blue line. Sent back out, and now a whistle goes as it hits something in the bench, or no, it's offside at the steel blue line. 8.6. seconds on the clock. Face off to the left of Lavoie. Will this be the final one of the first period? Pino with a shot right on. Lavoie stopped that through traffic. Did a great job to see it. 3 seconds left now. They're going to pin it to the wall, and the period will come to a close. 7-4 shots on goal in favor of Steele after 20 minutes. And your score through one period of play in game number 9 at the Atlantics. The Moncton Flyers, 0. The Steele Subaru U18s, 0. Host committee would like to thank Steele Subaru Halifax, the official sponsor of this game number 9. We're going to pause for the first intermission. We'll come back and tee up the second period action in about 13 and a half minutes time. You are watching the 2024 U18 AAA Atlantic Hockey Championships on AO Live. Welcome back to Lance. Teams are on the ice, almost set to go for period two, game number 9 out of 11 at this 2024 U18 AAA Atlantic Hockey Championship. Mike Barkhouse and Ashton Rieke with you. What a pace to this hockey game so far. It's been a treat to watch. No score between the Moncton Flyers and the Steel Subaru U18s after 20 minutes of play. Shots on goal in that first period, 7-4 in favor of the Subs. One power play apiece in that first period. Obviously, neither team were able to convert. That's pretty much all you need to know. One more game in the round robin. It comes up after this one, 3 p.m. Atlantic time, 3:30 p.m. Newfoundland time. The Halifax Max and Pinnacle Growlers will meet and finish up their round robin. Growlers are eliminated from contention. Max have it all to play for. Subs here trying to put all the pressure in the world on their in-league rivals, the Max. Subaru can jump the Max into the final spot in the finals here with a win. They would prefer a 3-point win to a 2-point win. But they're still going to need some help from the Growlers against the Max. That's the bad news for the Stoobs. You can do whatever you got to do here, do your part, but you can still be upended due to no fault of your own. A 3-point win for Steele here will put them 2 points in front of Halifax, so they will need Halifax to lose or win in overtime or a shootout, and then goal difference will come into play. A Halifax win in regulation should clinch them a spot against Kensington in the final. Underway, second period. Got standings on my brain. Here comes Weber now, and Jean, he's in. Jean, stopped by Lavoie with the right pad. Now as I look to my left, I think France Bergevin-Jean, the Tampa Bay Lightning goaltender coach, is here again to see Neka play. That's Neka Jean's dad. I thought he was leaving town after last night's game, or yesterday's game, but appears he's still here. Maybe he's going to catch a flight after this game and head back to the Lightning. Countway to Stevens. O'Donnell sends that down low. Mackinnon bumps his man, O'Brien. That shot is redirected on the way in by Stevens. Loic Nadeau fights that off. Both he and Lavoie have been solid in this first 21 minutes or so of action. LeBlanc over to Dagg. Dagg through to Pino. Over to LeBlanc. Can't get the shot away. Now centering pass. Dagg had his stick hit by Kavanaugh just in the nick of time. Sends that puck skyward. Dagg shakes his head. Just the one goal in this tournament for Liam Dagg. 8-7 shots on goal now in favor of Steele. Faceoff will come and neutralize in front of the Moncton bench. Still scoreless here in Lance. The East Hants Sportsplex. It's been a great host to this event. Crowds have been good all week long. Again, from everything I can see, and here it's been a great, successful event. Haven't heard anything to the contrary. Baxter gets that to Summers out the near side. There's a shot from the point from Sear. Not sure how much of that Lavoie saw till the last minute. He stuck his arm up and it goes over the goal. Now this one goes out of play for a whistle. This second period hasn't quite been as pacey as the first, but lots of time for that to change. I expect it to. But again, it's hard to maintain, even for kids like this age, in this physical condition. It's hard to maintain that pace of that first period through 60 minutes. That was a blistering pace, back and forth. Richard with a quick shot off the draw. Lavoie kicks that out. Sear now over to Gucci. Gucci, wrist shot, blocker to side by Lavoie as well. Sear over to Gucci, just keeps it at the blue line. Heavy wrist shot. Blocker down by Lavoie, and he's got it. You can see why Jacob Gucci is going to be a high pick in this summer's Q draft. Big, mean, can skate, and he's got a heavy, heavy shot on that blue line. It's going to make somebody happy. When he fills out, say when he's, you know, 18, 19 years old, he's going to be a big presence on somebody's blue line. As is Connor Sturgeon, number three out there right now. But we know whose blue line he's going to be on, at least to begin his junior career. It's going to be the Rimouski Oceanic. Sturgeon. Wrist shot through traffic, redirected by Béliveau. That's off the side of the goal. Béliveau back to Sturgeon. Sturgeon tries to fire another shot through traffic. Mäkinen's bumping him. Now comes to the far corner. Manders and Seau give chase. Seau pokes it down low. Subs repossess it. Now Prince to the near corner, being marked by Béliveau. Here we come, the boys in blue. McQueen down the wing. He's got Mäkinen racing to join him. Wade sends it over. Mäkinen scores! Tucker Mäkinen with a beautiful redirect on the backhand. And the Subs lead it 1-0. Tucker Mäkinen, I almost said it in the first period, that he's due for a goal the way he's played. He's had several scoring chances. His hustle, his speed creating, he's been so good for the Subs in this tournament. He deserved a goal, and he gets it there. Not only did he get it, but the good hands. That was not an easy redirect. That was on the backhand, a hard, hard pass. To be able to backhand that accurately past Loic Nadeau, good stuff there from Tucker Mäkinen. 3 minutes into the second period, Steele have the first goal that they desired. As this shot doesn't get through. First of the tournament for Mäkinen. McQueen with an assist. McQueen and Manders with the assist on that Tucker Mäkinen goal. Subs one goal to the good here. It's not a semifinal, but it's pretty close. There is no semifinals in this event. It's a straight round robin and then top two to the final. Kensington are there, awaiting their opponent. LeBlanc, skate to stick, shoots. Lavois stopped that, had no idea where it went from there. Well, it went to the near corner, and now Jace Evans comes away with it. Evans lugs that puck up ice, gets it over to Steve, well, looking for Stevens. He can't come up with that, but now Stevens angles off mode, ice, shoots, it's up in the air, and it's knocked away by O'Brien. Back on the Flyers now, Diag over to LeBlanc. LeBlanc chops that down low. Kavanaugh first to it behind the Subs goal. Brendan O'Donnell chops that ahead. Caleb Sear back for it inside his own blue line. Sear to Gucci. Now Countway takes over, lookout. That almost gave the linesman a haircut on the far side. Gucci now over to Sear. Sear. Back to Pino. That's knocked out by Burke, and now Burke's going to try and catch up to this. Hauled down by Pino. Stick was held a little bit as well. Referees let them play. Now O'Donnell. This is Brennan. Cuts out front. Can't slide underneath. Shot right there. Blocked. Off the stick of Brady Burke. Countway down low for Aiden O'Donnell. To Brady Burke. Good job to get that shot away. That's all he could do over there. Kavanaugh tries to keep it in. Can't now. 3-on-1 the other way perhaps. Dag looking for Pino. He can't corral that. Now Pino fires out front. Redirected by Dag. It just slowed it down. Steele tries to clear now. Burke looking for Brennan O'Donnell. That's poked away from him by Sturgeon. Aiden O'Donnell picks it up. Aiden O'Donnell over to Brennan, takes it off the skate to the stick. And that's broken up by Zach Gill. Liam Dagg flips it out to neutral ice. Burke makes a move on Baxter. Now Burke lifts it in on the backhand. Lee Shaw redirects this in. Lavois stays in the net. Here comes O'Donnell. This is Owen O'Donnell with speed. Drops it for Mäkinen. Stepping in front of that is Zach Gill, and that offensive rush will go no further. Sturgeon makes a move on Stevens. Sturgeon, far blue line for Summers, and this is going to be blown dead on the offside. That took a deflection, and that always throws the rhythm off. Face-off in neutral ice across from us. 6 minutes exactly gone in the second period. Steel Subaru leads 1-0 on Tucker Mackinnon's first of the tournament. Halifax Moosehead draft pick. This one's sent in. Lavois sticks that away. Seau now has it in the near corner for Moncton. Seau reverses to Bork. Bork gives that away. And Stevens flips it ahead. Big hit down in front of the Moncton bench. Stevens on the receiving end. Now an offside call. I didn't hear a whistle. I saw everybody standing still. No penalty. I didn't see anybody's arm in the air. Faceoff will come in neutral ice in front of the Sioux bench. Shots on goal even at 11 apiece. 13:30 to go, second period. We've got ourselves another good hockey game here at Atlantics. Tell me if you've heard that one before. Subs now to near side. Manders. Rashad. That just goes wide. Nadeau didn't see it whatsoever. LeBlanc. Lifts this off the glass and out of play. The 221s, LeBlanc and Béliveau share a word. Not overly hostile, but probably not overly nice either. 12:59 to go, second period. McQueen, back to the point. McQueen battling down there with Austin Sanchez. Manders tried to get it through to Owen O'Donnell. Back comes Gucci now. Gucci over to Sanchez. He'll chop that in. Manders gives chase along with Nekajon. Weber back to Sear. Sear, wrist shot, doesn't get to the net. Good block there by Manders, and he'll lift it out. Nagucci trying to keep Owen O'Donnell from that puck, and he does so nicely. Stretch pass to Weber, finds it, makes a move on Kavanaugh, puts Nekajon offside. Now they tag up. Nifty play there. Subs fans don't like it, but it was onside. 12 minutes to go in the second. Gucci across to the bench. Gill enters the fray. Sturgeon walks to the middle. Wrist shot, pad save, Lavois. Gill's got it near corner. Zach Gill back to Sturgeon. Sturgeon over to Weber. Weber back to Sturgeon. Sturgeon shot blocked by O'Donnell. Spinning and firing is Jean. A couple more saves for Lavois there. Subs trying to clear. They will now. They'll skate it out, actually. Here comes Brennan O'Donnell. Try to slide it through to Aiden in the slot. Doesn't work. Now it goes down around. Burke off the bench to meet it on the far in the half board, sorry. Down for Aiden. Too far for him. Gill pokes it to the corner, but Brennan O'Donnell's there to meet it. O'Donnell makes a move. O'Donnell trying to maintain possession. Jean takes that from him, but gives it away to Burke. Shot towards goal. Gill recovers and knocks that up and over the glass and out of play for a stoppage. 13-11, the shots on goal in favor of Moncton. But it's the Subs with a 1-0 lead. 11-12 to go, second period on AO Live. Moray pokes this down to O'Brien as the Flyers control off the draw. Pino bumped by Aiden O'Donnell. Now give away. Pino's got it again. He's attacking with speed. Knocked off his stick. LeBlanc couldn't come up with it. Now Burke comes away. Burke over to Brendan O'Donnell. Trying to feed Aiden. Too far for him. Moray has it now. Moray. That's going to be offside. LeBlanc was ahead of the play at the near blue line as the pass went to the far blue line. LeBlanc not happy with himself. ...10:46 to go. O'Brien, wrist shot. Goes just wide. Day. Moray. Can't get it down to the corner. McPhee comes away with it. Gets it to Mäkinen. Back to McPhee. McPhee shoots, save, rebounds, and they score! Tucker Mäkinen has two! That is 2-0 Steel Subaru! Tucker Mäkinen finally being repaid for his hard work and effort in this tournament. Has not one but both of the Steel Subaru goals. 10-19 to go in the second. It's 2-0 for the boys in blue. Probably could have had an empty netter earlier in the tournament. Busted out with speed, but he fed it to Stevens unselfishly. That's a big, big insurance goal right there. Aiden O'Donnell and Cole McPhee with the assists on that goal. So Aiden O'Donnell has another point. Mackinnon's going to be an important player for the Subs in the championship if they are to get there. But they're not there yet. And again, if you need reminding, Subs need to win, preferably for them a three-point win. But a regardless of what Steele does here, a regulation win for Halifax against Pinnacle at 3 p.m. will send Halifax to the final against Kensington. No matter what, Steele could win by 10 goals here. If Halifax win in regulation at 3 p.m., it's a Kensington-Halifax final. If Halifax does not win in regulation, if they win in overtime or a shootout, and Steele gets a three-point win here, then it comes down to goal difference. Actually, no, it would be head-to-head would be the first. So Halifax would win that as well. So, yeah. So, essentially, Steele's going to need Pinnacle to do them a favor and beat the Max. Either in regulation or in overtime or a shootout. I don't think a Max win of any kind will get Steele to the final. And again, there's a chance in front. Oh, Nadeau stopped it, but the rebound squirted through and they score! Looks like Jace Evans with the redirect. And it's 3-0 Subs, and they're on their way. It was a great stop by Nadeau coming across as that puck was going underneath him. He had the pass together, but it just squeaked underneath him enough for Evans to bang home the rebound into the open net. 8:48 to go in the second. It's 3-0 Steel U18. So yeah, just to finish that thought on the standings, a Halifax win of any kind will send them to the final against Pinnacle. Of course, the Subarus to qualify for the final, is provided they hang on here and win in regulation, they will need an overtime loss or a regulation loss for Halifax. They will need a loss of some kind. So we'll see what happens. They're doing their part so far. That's all you can ask of them. You don't want to have to leave it your fate into somebody else's hands, but sometimes that's how these things go in these events. And the thinnest of margins, the reason why it is that way, and it's harsh, but that win, that tournament opening win for Steele hurt them a little bit because they won in overtime and not in regulation. So it was a 2-point win instead of a 3-point win. So you recall Eddie Doyle tying things up in the last minute of play off of a faceoff. It was a 1-0 Steel Subaru lead in that game versus Kensington. Eddie Doyle tying it in the last minute, sending it to overtime. Steel winning eventually, but that cost Steel an ever-important point in the standings, and it might well be the point that cost them a trip to the finals. Unbelievable when you think about it that way. But that's the reality of the situation. as unbelievable as it may be, or as harsh as it may be. That is the reality. I could talk this stuff all day. Don't we have a great game? I love it. 7:13 to go, second period. Mackinnon's hurt after blocking that shot. Not the first time we've said that either. He's in a lot more pain this time, though, than the last time he blocked a shot. He hit him in the hand the last time, not today. But he is really limping around good down there. Now he's going to get to the bench, not putting a lot of weight on that left foot after blocking the shot. Hopefully Tucker will return. He's got two of the three steal goals today. Manders sends it towards goal. Now turning and firing is Sanford. That goes wide. Luke Moray was wide on his numerical counterpart, Prince. Then Prince recovers and knocks that away from him. There's a shot right on. Lavoie fights that off. Don't count Moncton out yet. Penalty coming to the Flyers. It's going to be a slash, and it's going to be Nekajan taking another penalty. I said it. He can lose his temper at times, as good as he is, as individually skilled as he is. Sometimes he goes to the penalty box a little too much, or at least he has in this tournament. First power play of the period coming up for Steele, second of the afternoon. 6:21 to go, second period. Chance to extend the lead even further, and a power play goal here might just do it. A four-goal deficit at this event is tough to come back from. Countway. Zuchukwu spins away from Baxter. Still has it, now sends it down low for Jace Evans. Has the most recent Steele Subaru goal. Stevens. Now back to the point to Countway, mishandles it, and out it comes. Now he's got to withstand the pressure from LeBlanc. He does. Countway brings it in, flips it deep. Rimmed around. Squirts through Owen O'Donnell and goes the length of the ice. Lavoie waits for it down there. He'll leave it for Countway. Just about a minute to go in this Steele Subaru power play. Their second of the day. Now, there's a redirect, or an intercept story. Sanchez, shorthand. He's got Weber with him. Gets it over to him. Weber kicks it to the stick, to the backhand. Ran out of real estate, and Lavoie stops it. Lavoie, solid between the pipes. That save number 15 in the afternoon for him. Several have been to the very good to excellent variety. Aiden O'Donnell now takes a chop and gets it ahead. Brennan O'Donnell. He rims this around. Burke waits for it. Burke sends it back to Aiden O'Donnell. Aiden O'Donnell, down low for Brady Burke. Back to O'Donnell. Prince to Aiden O'Donnell. 15 seconds to go on the Steele power play. Look out. That was coming right up into my forehead without that mesh there. Yeah, we were getting ready. We had the trappers out. 13 seconds to go in the Steele power play. 4:34 to go in the second. 3-0, Steele Subaru leading. Two goals from Tucker Mackinnon and one from Jace Evans. Second in the tournament for Evans. Uzuchukwu. As the penalty comes to a close, Flyers kill it off. Steele 0 for 2 today. That shot from Uzuchukwu goes wide. Sidebash. Now the net's off as Nadeau comes across. You can see him put his hand in the air saying, my bad, that one's on me. Knocked it off as he slid across. Faceoff should come out in neutral ice as it was the goaltender that knocked that off. Are they going to keep this faceoff in the zone? Even though Nadeau knocked it off? Looks like they are. 4:13 to go, second period. O'Brien, far corner, moves it ahead. Simon Bork skates it ahead. Gets it over to Liam Dagg. Pino going to the net. So does Bork. Toe dragon shot from Liam Dagg. Stopped and held by Lavoie. Continues to be solid. That's 16 saves now in the afternoon for him. Faceoff coming to Lavoie's left now. Late stages, second period. Now here comes Tucker Mackinnon. Good to see him back out there after taking that shot off his foot. See if it dents his speed a little bit. Down Mackinnon bumped from behind by Bork. Sturgeon has it behind the goal. Bork comes away with it. Gets it out. Evans picks it up inside his own blue line. Now Dagg lost the handle as he went to the net. Sturgeon, wrist shot, kicked aside. We'll go with that by Brandon Lavoie. Just about 3 minutes to play. Second period. Pino loses it. Sturgeon picks it up. Drops to Pino. Now this one's lifted out by Cole McPhee, and that's going to go for icing. .256 to play. Morey now. Can't get to that. Now he does. He's got it in the corner. He's being harassed down there by McPhee. Baxter. Bumped off the puck by Mokryakov. 2.5 to go in the second. Comes back to the point. Kept in nicely by Rishaw. Now he's hauled down a bit. Referee's arm stays down. O'Brien, snap shot, save. Rebounds there from Morey. That's stopped by Lavoie as well. Kryakov being hounded. Under 2 minutes to go, second period. Bork's shot blocked. Soups can't clear yet. Now skating it out is Brady Burke. Ahead to Brendan O'Donnell. He overskates it, and that put himself in an offside position as well. Now he gets it back. O'Donnell. Over to Aiden O'Donnell. Shoots. That goes wide. I misspoke on that Jace Evans goal. Tucker Mackinnon second goal. I said Aiden O'Donnell got an assist. It was Owen O'Donnell with the primary assist. McPhee with the second. So Mackinnon second from Owen O'Donnell and Cole McPhee. Here's Sturgeon in. Airmails that one up into the mesh, and he slaps the glass in frustration. 1:18 to go in the second. The most recent steal goal, I should say. Jace Evans, second of the tournament from Stevens and McQueen. So McQueen's got a pair of helpers in this game. The energy guys getting it done for Steele today and Marty King. LeBlanc. Sends it back to the point. Too hot for Countway to handle. Now he battles with Weber. Under a minute to go. Second period. Here's a shot. They score! Austin Sanchez gets the Flyers on the board in the final minute of the second. And don't look now. We've got ourselves a brand new hockey game. It's 3-1. 54 and a half ticks to go. Sanchez opens his account. He had 3 points in the first game, nothing since. No chance for Lavoie on that blistering shot. Flyers back in it. They need it, that one, in a big way. I said they couldn't go down four, and they don't. Now they're down by two. Trying to get the assist here. So muffled here, the sound. It's almost impossible to hear, and it gets me again there. Seconds to go, second period. Weber and Sturgeon. The assist on that goal. There's another shot stopped by Lavoie. Seconds to go in the period now. Moraes. Battling down there, trying to get it to LeBlanc. 5 seconds to go. Looks like they're going to scrum it in the corner for the remainder of the period. Now it comes free. Dag fires. Blocked by Manders, and the period comes to a close. Exciting end of the second, though. Flyers getting back in it. 21-14 shots on goal in favor of Moncton through 40 minutes, and your score after two periods of play in game number 9. The Steel Subaru U18s 3, the Moncton Flyers 1. The host committee would like to thank Steel Subaru of Halifax, a special official sponsor of this game number 9. We're going to pause for the second intermission now, come back, run down the scoring summary for you in about 13 and a half minutes' time. You are watching the 2024 U18 AAA Atlantic Hockey Championships on AO Live. Welcome back to Lance. Flyers are on the ice. Subs will join them shortly. Game number 9, second to last game of the round robin at the 2024 U18 AAA Atlantic Hockey Championships. Third period about to begin. 3-1. Steel Subaru leading after two periods of play. Mike Barkhouse and Ashton Ricky with you here on AO Live, the home of the Atlantic Hockey Championships. Let's run down the scoring summary for you quickly before we get the start of the third. No scoring in the first period. That one's easy. Shots on goal after one were 7-4 in favor of Steel Subaru. In the second period, Subs would open the scoring. Tucker Mackinnon, his first of the tournament. McQueen and Manders with the assist made it 1-0. Mackinnon would score again, second of the day, second of the tournament. Owen O'Donnell and McPhee with the assist. It was 2-0 Steel Subaru. Jace Evans would add to the Steel lead, his second of the tournament. Stevens and McQueen with the assist. 3-0 Steel Subaru, but then before the end of the period, Austin Sanchez, his second of the tournament. Nathan Weber and Connor Sturgeon with the assist. 3-1 Subaru, Steel Subaru as it stands now. Shots on goal through 40 minutes. 21-14 in favor of Moncton. Brandon Lavoie has been solid in the Steel Subaru goal. Moncton 0-for-1 on the power play today. Steel Subaru 0-for-2. So there you go. Third period underway, and it's a big one. Again, Steel Subaru needs to win to keep their hopes of going to the finals alive. Here's O'Donnell scores right off the faceoff, essentially 12 seconds into the third, and the Subarus have extended their lead, or restored more accurately, their 3-goal lead. Second of the tournament for Brendan O'Donnell. That's a big goal right there. A lot of the fans aren't even settled back into their seats yet, and it's 4-1 Steel Subaru. See who the assists go to again. Second of the tournament for Brendan O'Donnell. That's a big in. 4-1. Aiden O'Donnell now. Over to Brady Burke in the corner. He'll take it behind the goal. Now Brendan's got it in the far corner. Comes out, turns, fire, stop, rebounds there. Burke couldn't whack it home before the Flyers clear. Pino pokes that past Manders. And now Prince takes it behind his goal out the far side. Now spins back. O'Donnell, it's Brendan across to Burke over the blue line. Aiden stays onside nicely. Burke sends it through to the near side. Mackinnon sends it down low. Just going to pause here and get the assist. Burke and Aiden O'Donnell with the assist. So the top line, all contributing on that one. The O'Donnells continue to impress for Subaru. Kavanaugh can't get that away at the blue line. Here comes Summers in all alone. Jackson Summers shoots, blocker saved by Lavoie. So if this score holds and it's a 3-point regulation win for Steel Subaru, they will move into second place and into the final spot in the finals. But Halifax finishes their round robin against Pinnacle Growlers here at 3 p.m. Atlantic time. A win of any kind for Halifax will send them to the final versus Pinnacle. So Steel Subaru needs a loss of some kind for Halifax, be it in regulation or in overtime or a shootout. And you know the Macs aren't going to do the Subs any favors. 2 minutes gone, at least on purpose. 2 minutes gone, third period. 4-1 Steel Subaru here. And if this holds, what a disappointing Atlantic's tournament for the Moncton Flyers. After starting off on such a positive note with a nice win over the Pinnacle Growlers, it'll be 3 straight losses if this result holds for this Flyers team. But in these short tournaments, you know, anything can happen. We've all seen them through the years. Just when we think we've got this game of ours figured out, it throws us another curveball. I think it's the second baseball reference I've used this week as well. I'm a sportsman, if nothing else. Sayo redirects this in. Almost went into the basketball hoop down there. McQueen waits for it on the near wall. Manders sends it far side. Stevens will chop at it. Just gets it out. Sayo's got it. Back to Zach Gill. Ahead to Beliveau. Beliveau can't come up with that clean. Prince will go back and get it. Drops it for Manders. McQueen picks it up. And that's knocked out. No icing as Gill's back for it. Supers are changing, so Gill's got some extra time. Gets it over to Connor Sturgeon. He's got an assist in this one. He'll lift it in. And might this be the final U18 game of Connor Sturgeon's Moncton career? Next stop, Rimouski. Sturgeon takes a bump from behind. He felt that one. That was Aiden O'Donnell getting into him. Sturgeon going right to the bench. He's a little foggy after that. Don't think many people noticed that, but yeah, Sturgeon definitely not feeling great after that hit from Aiden O'Donnell. Looking at him on the bench, getting himself together. Weber, O'Brien, shot doesn't get through. Now it's still loose at the side. Jean can't find it. Moray down low. Soups take over. O'Brien, it's a back shot redirected by Jean. Good alert pad saved by Lavoie, and now that's lifted over the glass and out of play. ...23-16, the shots on goal in favor of Moncton. They're out shooting the Sioux, but they're trailing by three. Frustrating from a Moncton perspective. O'Brien to Moray. Moray, wrist shot, blocker to the corner by Lavoie. Moray gets it back, far point. Settles the puck down, wrist shot right on. Another save by Lavoie. Puck is loose at the front. Weber couldn't find it for a shot. And now away comes Mokryakov. Mokryakov sends it on goal. Steered aside by Loek Nadeau. Now redirect by Moray right onto his own goal. Nadeau had to be alert there and was. Loek Nadeau and Simon Camier have split the net for Moncton in this tournament. Owen O'Donnell, he's got an assist this afternoon. A cross-ice pass goes nowhere, and now here comes Neka Jean. He's been quiet offensively since game one, but he's got all the skill in the world. 5 minutes gone in this third period. Gucci back in his own end. Sear over for Jean. He'll get the red line, chop that in. Lavoie stops it there for Prince. This one sails over the goal. Nadeau looked like he was going to jump up and grab it and elected to let it fall. Now here comes Liam Dagg. Dagg right down Main Street. Goes to the end boards for it. Dagg tried to get it back to Gucci. A little too hot for him to handle. Now he'll have to regroup. Gucci. Tries to slide it through to LeBlanc. Picked up by Pino. Jacob Pino. Bumped. Dagg picks it up. Tries to slide it to LeBlanc. Good read there by the Sioux to break that up. And now away comes Wyatt Countway. He'll lift this to the blue line. Sturgeon back out there. That's good to see. Hopefully he's still feeling all right. Dagg now. Cross to LeBlanc. LeBlanc lifts this in. Lavoie loves to come out and play it, and he will. Most of the goaltenders in this tournament are comfortable playing the puck. It's a skill that most goaltenders nowadays have to have. Back in my day, it was notable when you say, oh, this guy likes to play the puck, because there weren't too many that did like to play the puck. Most of them now, it's kind of a facet of your game that you need to have at least some competency in. Some guys never used to be able to do it at all. It'd be like they were glued to that blue paint. They wouldn't even leave. Not anymore. It's a changing game that we have. 7 minutes gone in the third. Baxter with speed. Wide. Gets right through the crease. And a shot. Couldn't catch up to that. Now Owen O'Donnell back the other way. Trying to turn Moray inside out. O'Donnell shoots. That's blocked nicely by O'Brien. Now back comes Elisha the other way. He'll lift this in. and give chase as well. Here come the Supes. Aiden O'Donnell around Dami Seo. Try to get it to Burke. That's taken away by Moray, and away he goes. Luc Moray. Likely destined for Grand Falls next year in the Maritime Hockey League or somewhere else in that league. O'Donnell. Brennan kicks this up. He's got the most recent goal in this one. 12 seconds into the third period to restore the three-goal Subes lead and give them a bit more of a comfortable cushion. Everybody likes a comfy cushion, don't they? This one slides onto Lavoie, and he'll hold it. 26-17, shots on goal in favor of Moncton. They continue to outshoot the Subes by, I won't say a considerable margin, but by a notable margin, we'll say, enough to make note of. 11:52 to go in the third. 4-1 Steel Subaru U18. Back underway now, Gucci inside his own blue line. Sends it over to Sear. Mäkinen brings it in, shoots right on, that's stopped. Cleared by Gucci. Prince. Over to Mäkinen. Seo, his folks, his family just down a couple rows in front of me here. He'd like to score one in front of them at Atlantics. Here comes Owen O'Donnell now. Tries to get around Gucci. Gucci with that red sweater might as well be a big stop sign. Do not pass. Sanchez back to Weber. Try to get it back to Sanchez. That comes out over the blue line. Gill's got it in front of the Subes bench. We're approaching the halfway mark of the third now. Sturgeon. Over the blue line, wrist shot. That didn't miss by a lot. Comes off the end glass, hit Lavoie. Lucky for Lavoie, it didn't get behind him. Sanchez now. Too far for Sturgeon on the far side. Now here comes Sanford. Touches it to LeBlanc, and that comes off his stick. Gill moves it ahead looking for Weber in front of his own bench. Kavanaugh takes over, gets it to Countway. Sanchez gets a stick on that pass. And now Weber can't take that away. Gill down to get it. Reverses it for Sturgeon. Sturgeon lifts this ahead, booted ahead by Countway. Now Sturgeon. To LeBlanc, sends it in. Nadeau can't stop it behind the goal. We are past the halfway mark of the third now. Will the Flyers make a late charge? Or will the Subes put it in cruise control the rest of the way? See what I did there? Subaru, cruise control. Sometimes I amaze even myself. Bag sends this down low. Lavoie leaves it. McQueen in front of his own bench. He's got two assists today. Mäkinen, he's got two goals. Send it over to Jace Evans. This line has three of the four Subaru goals. What a performance by the energy line today. Dag cuts inside. Mäkinen can't clear at first on second effort. Also cannot. 109 to go in the third. Pino on the backhand tries to cut out front. He and Manders battle down there in the far corner. Prince over to Manders. LeBlanc tried to get a leg on that clearance, couldn't. Now O'Brien is dumped. He and McQueen battle for the puck, and Dag takes over. McQueen heads to the bench for a change. Good piece of uninterrupted play here. It's been a while since we've heard a whistle, and you know what's going to happen now. We're going to get one, and there it is. I'm not normally the kiss of death or the party pooper, but I have my moments. 26-18, the shots on goal in favor of the Flyers, but it is a 4-1 Steel Subaru lead, 8:17 to go in the third. Aiden O'Donnell stick handling in a phone booth. Got that shot away. Not sure if it hit. I think it hit something before it got to Nadeau. It didn't go in. That's the best I can tell you. 8 minutes to go in the third. That's how close Steel Subaru are to at least doing their part of controlling their destiny. The rest will be up to their rivals, the Halifax Max. It's almost, it's poetic, isn't it? It comes down to these, this time of year and these types of games and tournaments where these bitter rivals end up having to control one another's destinies and fates in these tournaments. It's just a beautiful thing. That's why we love sports. It's the greatest drama there is. Baxter through the legs of Mokryakov. To Summers. To Rashad turns and fires to no one. Baxter over there, he'll grab it. He and his numerical counterpart, Stevens, came together briefly. Sturgeon to Rashad. Rashad waiting for help. Help is not on the way. Flyers were in the midst of a change. Sturgeon over to Gill. Sturgeon. Already has one player of the game award in this tournament. And this, for me, might be his best game of the whole thing. Lavoie plays this over to McPhee. Beliveau in on the forecheck. Subs come away. Tucker Mäkinen lifts this deep. Nadeau's going to play it now. He's going to have to hurry. Owen O'Donnell's right behind him. Assuming he knew that. Bork pokes it around his man, Manders. Now Prince lifts it off glass and out. O'Brien over for it for the Flyers. O'Brien takes it behind his own goal out the near side. O'Brien over to Luc Moraille. Moraille ahead to Sayo. Dami Sayo sends it in. Prince goes to get it. Beliveau watches him. Gives him a little bump. 6 minutes to go. Uzuchukwu tries to go wide on Moraille. Tries to sneak it in into the feet of Nadeau. That was a nifty move by Chike Uzuchukwu. Mäkinen to LeBlanc. Sorry, that was Sanford to LeBlanc. No shot forthcoming. Now here comes Austin Sanchez. 2 goals in the tournament. 4 points. O'Brien shoots. That didn't miss by much near post as it took a deflection on its way to the net. Gucci off the bench picks this up, spins and gives it ahead to O'Brien. O'Brien's got to hurry as Sanford was closing on him. Weber spins away from a check. Hits a stick and pops up in the air. Settled down by Kavanaugh. Here comes Elliot Kavanaugh being watched from behind by Sanchez towards the goal. Sear steps in front of that. Flyers take over. Weber to Sear. Sear. Is that behind goal? 5 minutes to go in the third. A reminder, final game of the round robin comes up about an hour and 15 minutes from now. 3 p.m. Atlantic, 3:30 p.m. Newfoundland time. So we get nice and call on the Subs. That will be the Halifax Max and the Pinnacle Growlers, champions of Newfoundland against the champions of Nova Scotia. And we'll know after that game who's going to play the Kensington Wild in tomorrow afternoon's Atlantic Championship Final. Regardless of who plays Kensington in that Atlantic Championship Final, we'll be here 1 p.m. Atlantic tomorrow afternoon on AO Live. Hope you will be as well. Gucci cuts inside, bumped off by Mokryakov. Now McPhee sends it around. Weber cuts inside, dishes it to Dagg, takes it off the skate, fans on the shot. Now away comes McQueen. 2 assists already for him today. Ryder McQueen sends it deep. Sturgeon there for that. Now McQueen and Weber exchange pleasantries. Weber not happy with McQueen. Delayed offside here, and they're going to blow it dead. With 4:08 to go, 26-18 shots on goal in favor of Moncton. It's always frustrating when you shoot an opponent handily, maybe come up short. McPhee over to Mokryakov. This one's sent deep. Nadeau stops it, plays it to Sturgeon. Sturgeon sweeps it ahead. Burke's going to keep that down low. Now here's Brendan O'Donnell. He's got one in this period already. Manders sends it deep. Gill. Ridden out by O'Donnell. Burks tries to send it for Aiden. Now Brennan sends it back to Manders at the far point. Manders, wrist shot through traffic, gloved and held by Loic Nadeau. .320 to go. Reminder, stay with us at the conclusion of this game. We'll stay with you for the player of the game presentations for each team. Got to think Tucker Mackinnon might hear his name called for the Subes in that regard. Here's a quick shot from Richard, stopped and held by Lavoie. It's either Mackinnon or Lavoie for me for Steel Subaru. Sanchez is a candidate for the Flyers. Sturgeon again, candidate. Probably won't give Sturgeon another one, though. Dag's been really good today for the Flyers as well. So I'm going to say one of those. Sanchez, Dag, or Sturgeon. And I'll probably be totally wrong. Mackinnon or Lavoie for me for Steel Subaru in terms of players of the game. And just to be clear, so I don't get any flack for this, I do not pick the players of the game. I'm saying who, for me, would be among my picks, but I do not make the selections. So if your favorite player that you feel is player of the game doesn't get it, your anger does not need to be directed at me. Kavanaugh. That doesn't get to goal. Morey stops that. Countway. Countway still in the corner. Takes a bump from Baxter. 2.5 to go in essentially this hockey game. It would be some story if the Flyers could erase this 3-goal deficit with this much time remaining. Wouldn't be the strangest thing I've ever seen. Not even close. Wouldn't be the strangest thing I've ever seen in this building. I did a Junior C Atlantics game a couple years ago here. East Hants against the Southwest Storm in the semifinal. And there was a 3-goal lead with about 1.5 minutes left. The Southwest team, East Hants, came back to tie it somehow. To this day, I don't know how. And then Southwest scored with 14 seconds left to win it in regulation. So that was the gosh darnest thing I've ever seen. So this wouldn't surprise me here. 1:47 to go. I don't think we'll see a goaltender pull here for John DeCourcy. Stevens controls off the draw. That's sent down. Sear. Sayo. Bumped there by Stevens. Squirts free, Stevens. Now it's sent down low by McPhee. 1.5 to go in the third. Béliveau. Gucci takes over. Spinning and firing that wide is Owen O'Donnell. Sorry, McQueen. Sayow. Now McQueen takes over. Cutting inside. Shot right there from Stevens. Goes wide. Mokryakov down low. Evans spinning. Loses it to Sturgeon. Now he gives it away. McQueen leans into that and it goes high and wide. Nekajon. 1-on-2. If anyone's going to stick handle through that, it's him. Under a minute to go. 45 seconds to be exact. Steel Subaru coming up big today when they need it to. And as I said, there were two facets to this in terms of their fate. Win this one in regulation. That was part one. Check. And now have the Halifax Max lose in some form to the Pinnacle Growlers. That is still to be determined. 20 seconds to go. Sturgeon with a shot. Stop. Rebound. Lob one. I think he got a piece of that, too, off of Jean's shot. Gill back for it. Ahead to the red line to Sturgeon. Sturgeon cuts to the middle. He's probably looking to get one final shot away. Yeah, there it is. It's blocked to the corner. Under 5 seconds to go. The fans come to life and salute their Subs. The Dartmouth Steel Subaru U18s celebrate with Brandon Lavoie as they defeat the Moncton Flyers by a score of 4-1. Disappointing tournament for the Flyers comes to an end. Not what they or many expected. But again, that's why we love this game. You just never know how things are going to go. Final shots 30-20 in favor of Moncton, so they did their part there. Just didn't get enough past Brandon Lavoie, who was fantastic in the Steel Subaru goal. So we'll stay with you for the player of the game's presentation. I've told you who my picks were. One game to go in the round robin. Teams are lined up on their respective blue lines. Waiting for the ceremony now. Presentations, more accurately, not ceremonies. Disappointing ends to the Atlantics for the Moncton Flyers, and you can see that disappointment on a lot of their faces. Austin Sanchez is the player of the game for the Flyers, so I got that one right. I think that was the hardest one to call. Tucker Mäkinen, player of the game for Steel Subaru. So two good choices there for player of the game. So that's going to wrap up game number 9. One game to go in the round robin here at the 2024 Atlantics. We'll know who takes on Kensington in the final after this upcoming 3 p.m. game. Subs have done their part. Now they need some help from the Pinnacle Growlers. Your final score in game number 9. The Steel Subaru U18s 4, the Moncton Flyers 1. Thank you for watching this afternoon on AO Live. Hope to see you back here at 3 p.m. Atlantic time, 3:30 p.m. Newfoundland time for the Growlers and the Max. Bye for now from the East Hand Sportsplex.